UP Law Professor Attorney Vicky Avena now joins us on the line. Attorney Avena, good morning.
Hi, good morning, Pinky.
All right, good morning, ma'am. So far yesterday, I guess in a way, ma'am, it was clear the difference or why 2.4 is being set aside right now. But maybe in very, very simple, a very simple explanation, you can tell our viewers what this means. Article 2 means now that 2.4 is being set aside, at least the one on ill-gotten wealth.
Oh, yes. Very good opportunity to clarify, because, Pinky, actually, what Senator Grillon tried to establish yesterday was to clarify that there was no ruling from the impeachment body regarding 2.4, which means that they are not saying no evidence should come in. Okay, so some reports are not accurate, no? Senator Grillon made it clear that Senate President Enrile did not say that the impeachment body is ruling on this. So if you don't rule on an article, it means evidence can come in. Secondly, the only thing that it should be clear further is that the body should not refer to it as ill-gotten wealth yet. Even if evidence shows that there are properties in the name of the Chief Justice, his wife, etc., they should not call it ill-gotten yet, because Senator Dillon said it is up to the law to presume that. And on top of that, if you may ask me, the defense still has the right to prove that it is not ill-gotten through their own evidence.
Yeah, because they're saying, attorney, that the Chief Justice could have had, or at least the family or the wife could have had, other sources of income. That's why the defense keeps saying, we're going to prove that these are not ill-gotten.
That is true, but that's the reason why the prosecution was allowed to present the income tax return equivalent, which is the alpha list, in order to show the discrepancy between the values of these properties and his present stated income in the alpha list.
So, attorney, this will connect the dots for the prosecution, what they're trying to prove, the Sal N, the alpha list, the income tax returns, and the properties that were already admitted as evidence and narrated by Kim Henares.
Yes, so they're trying to prove one culpable violation of the Constitution, because if you do not declare completely in your Sal N the true value of your assets, specifically the acquisition cost at the time you acquired it, then you are not complying with the Constitution, together with Republic Act 6713. On top of that, they were trying to show Republic Act 1379 for feature of ill-gotten wealth, precisely to show the elements so that the court can conclude, based on the law itself, that the properties of value that are manifestly out of proportion to your stated income are ill-gotten, because they could not.
Yeah. Yes, attorney, go ahead.
Yeah, because they could not support it by your income.
Yes, exactly. Okay, so exactly.
On top of that, yes. On top of that, they were finally, finally they were trying to prove 3019. That is in Article 2.3 of the impeachment complaint, for which evidence was allowed. 3019 refers to graft and corruption. And for that, we have to look to another case for comparison, if you will allow it. And I'm referring, of course, to Republic versus Sandigan Bay, in that case where the Marcoses were proved to have ill-gotten wealth in Switzerland.
In a way, Attorney Avena, at least it's clear that they haven't really ruled on 2.4. As stated by Senator Drilon, Senator Judge Drilon yesterday. But when we were speaking to Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile, it's as if on 2.2 and 2.3, for example, on 2.3, non-inclusion of assets in his Sal N, if it is found that there are properties that were not included in his Sal N, and if it was proven, it is proven that his income or other sources of income cannot sustain such properties, is it correct? I heard it somewhere. Is it correct to say that this is almost as if it can be described as ill-gotten, and the burden of proof will be on the defense to prove that it is not ill-gotten?
Okay. Right now, because the evidence has come in, the burden of evidence, now, which is different from burden of proof, is how they say, okay? The burden of now, the burden of evidence is now with the defense. We need to say the ball is in their court to show that they got these properties from legitimate or legal sources of income. If they do not prove that, Pinky, that is when the law itself will tell the judge, you should conclude that it is ill-gotten.
There you go.
That's what you mean by presumption. Yeah.
Yes. if they are not able to prove that they have enough income or they had enough income to purchase these properties, the law says this can be described automatically as ill-gotten.
You're correct.
I see. What other sources of income? You know where I'm confused, Attorney Avena, because after BIR Commissioner Kim Henares' testimony, she said that there was no filing of ITR from 2002 to 2010 by the Chief Justice. However, there was that alpha list, and stated there was the income and withholding tax of the Chief Justice from 2006 to 2010. First, ma'am, what happened between 2002 and 2005?
Maybe they should still produce the alpha list for that. I'm not sure that there was none. And there was no reason given for not touching on that as yet.
Yes, because we carried the impeachment yesterday, as we have been, and I'm pretty sure that there was no ITR 2002 to 2010, but an alpha list on 2006 to 2010. And I went back reading the papers, and it was the same.
Possibly, Pinky, too. It is not material in the sense that there were no properties acquired prior to 2006. You see, the only property possibly acquired was the La Vista thing, which was acquired in 2003.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So there was a property. There was a transaction in 2003.
In the name of the wife.
Christina.
Not the respondent.
That's right. Okay. I want to go to Mrs. Christina Corona in a while. But okay, so talking about that, we'll probably try to find out why there was no ITR or alpha list from 2002 to 2005. But Chief Justice is not allowed, or is he allowed to have other sources of income, ma'am?
Sure, why not? Like donations. If there's a very rich relative who wants to donate, $5 million to him, why not?
But any other source of income, my understanding, is this allowed? Is that true, ma'am?
You're talking about business.
Yes.
Because he's supposed to be a full-time official of the government. He cannot have business in the full-time sense of the word. He can own shares of stock.
Correct.
All right? So, yeah, legitimate investments like that are allowed, you know, but not in the sense that it will impinge on your judicial function. Apart,
I see.
Of course, from conflict of interest.
So, attorney, that means that he can still be part of a business or a corporation as long as it doesn't conflict with his schedule as
a
member of the judiciary, for example?
No, it's not just a matter of schedule. As Chief Justice, he's not supposed to engage in business. Engaging in business is different from just mere stockholding, because he can invest as a stockholder. But he cannot become officer or any other kind of official, like being a board director.
So he can invest as a stockholder?
Oh, I'm sure.
Yes,
because,
for example,
he has the right to own property.
Mm-mm. And he can invest in stocks. He can play with the stock in the stock market.
As long as he's not an active player in the sense that he is already part of the stock exchange. He cannot be a stock broker, for example.
Definitely. But so, in other words, he can have other sources of income. As you mentioned, for example, a donation. That could be a source of income that allows someone like him to be able to increase his net worth and subsequently buy properties. What other sources of income, ma'am? Is that clear? I mean, do we actually know what other sources of income he can have?
Okay, if you have a bank account, it will earn if you place it in time deposit.
Yes.
You can put it in the money market placement. Those
SDA,
kinds of investments.
Special deposit also.
Say it again.
SDAs, ma'am. Yung kita niya sa mga special deposits,
right? Yes, deposit accounts, yes.
Correct.
Yes,
okay.
Those are passive investments.
All right. Okay, now let's go very briefly to Mrs. Christina Corona. Can you help us understand that in 2003 she was a one-time taxpayer, but she had not reported any source of income, but she was able to buy a La Vista property also in 2003 for 11 million pesos. Offhand, attorney, is that already does that seem like it's wrong or illegal?
On its face, there is no explanation as to where she got the money to buy. And because, you see, if she had money, if that money was hers, the question is, why did she not report it for purposes of taxation?
Mm-mm.
On the other hand, if it is not hers, then she was acting as a dummy. As to the question whether we can conclude that, the conclusion is only prima facie or on its face, which leaves room for the defense to present evidence that will countervail it. But as it is right now, on the record, there is an anomaly, either under the tax laws or the anti-graft and corruption laws.
Offhand, and you can say that. Yeah.
Yes, on top of that, if it is established that she was an official of the Camp John Hay Development Corporation, then another question arises, precisely. She should have filed a SAL-N, in which she should have declared that property in respect of correct acquisition costs.
I see.
If you compared with the ITR or the Alpha List, the question comes in, as you said, where did she get the money to buy that?
Yeah, but I guess you also are aware that there is that 11 million peso cash advance that they took from a corporation owned by Mrs. Cristina's family, the Basa Gidote Enterprise Incorporated.
I heard, yes.
Yeah, so if I'm not mistaken, attorney, that's also around 2010. So this actually might possibly explain this 11 million purchase of that La Vista property, because it was almost around the same time, if I'm getting it correct.
Let me try to understand. The La Vista property was supposed to have been purchased by Mrs. Corona, but the 11 million loan was supposed to have been taken out by the Chief Justice from the company of the wife.
That's right.
So is it being implied that the Chief Justice borrowed from the wife's corporation in order to lend it for the wife to buy the property? Is that the implication here?
Possible, ma'am? That's my question. If they connect those two, is that a possibility? Does that explain the 11 million transaction and the 11 million cash advance? This is, of course, hypothetical in the event that the defense uses that or explains that to us.
Okay. At this point, then, we have to refer to a piece of information that is not yet part of the record in the impeachment case,
right.
i.e., the report of Ms. Raisa Robles to the effect that in 2003, the charter of Basa Gidote Corp. was already revoked by the SEC. Yeah. Mm-hmm. The implication of that, Pinky, is that if a charter is revoked, it cannot transact business anymore for the purpose for which it was incorporated.
Yeah.
Meaning, after revocation of charter, you only have 3 years within which to wind up your affairs. Meaning, liquidate your assets, collect, pay creditors, then distribute all assets to stockholders, and within those 3 years, after you accomplish that, you stop, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're able to accomplish within 2 years, you stop operating, you do not exist anymore.
Yeah.
But if you need 3 years to do that, then after 3 years, meaning say 2003 to 2007 or 2008 or so, at the moment you're able to liquidate finally, you stop existing.
Mm-hmm.
And so the question is, how could they have taken out a loan in 2003 from a corporation whose charter was already revoked, if the report is true?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, because
right.
That hasn't been entered as evidence during the impeachment trial. We're just looking, trying to look forward, attorney, because of course the defense is very confident. At least they're telling us that they will be able to explain all this in due time. All right, so attorney, today we are expecting again the continuation of the testimony of Kim Henares. What do you think? What else should we look forward to today in today's trial?
As you noted, there were no Alpha Lists presented for the months covering the period before 2006. If that is relevant at all in respect of whether properties were acquired during that time, then they will have to touch on that. Otherwise, it's a hole. It's a big hole.
Yeah. We were discussing that, the 2002 to 2005. No ITR,
yes.
No Alpha List.
Yes. On top of that, I think they want to inquire into the income tax returns of the children and the in-law.
Yeah.
Because that's related to 2.3 and 2.4.
Pero hindi ba, Attorney Avena, hindi pa yan pinayagan ng Senator Judges so far?
They were debating it yesterday and that's where it was cut off.
Mm-mm.
But as to whether there was a final decision as to papayagan o hindi, hindi pa natin alam.
Right.
Nasa debate pa tayo.
Kasi ang pinayagan, obviously ang pinayagan lang kahapon is kay Chief Justice at kay Mrs. Corona.
Correct.
There's still a question mark on the kids and the in-laws.
Yes, but if I may say, as to lang, Senate President Enrile already mentioned earlier that the income tax returns of the wife, evidence in general, Sabina, evidence in general regarding the wife and the children and the son-in-law will be covered. Ruling na yun ni Senate President.
O, edi ilalabas yun, ma'am, siguro today.
Okay, nagtataka ako, may debate pa eh. Yeah, if you really pay attention to the rulings, you will see it.
Well, all right. Kasi marami hong nasasabi din si presiding officer that needs further explanation. For example, ma'am, hindi ho ba, it was very evident when he ruled on the 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, there were still a lot of questions after that. That's why you had a Senator Jilon having to come to the podium and explain that further. Well, all right. So today should be, I guess, the same, except it'll probably be less tedious in the sense that there will be less of the markings of the documents as evidence.
Maybe. Kasi we don't know how many proper...
Hindi kasi, di ba, parang iniutos na nila na gawin yan at a much earlier time, although the prosecution kept saying they were there yesterday since 8 a.m., pero hindi pa rin natapos yung kanilang marking ng evidence.
Correct.
All right, so one last note, attorney. What about the bank documents? What's your what can you tell us about that?
They have subpoenaed, no, bank documents from five banks, and if you ask me, there is basis for that. The legal basis has been laid in respect of evidence on income, and therefore, if we are going to be proper, all of these should be allowed on the basis of the past events.
Mm-mm. And there's something in the law, attorney, that says that, I was asking about the bank secrecy law. There are exceptions, and one exemption would be an impeachment case. Is that correct?
Yes, absolutely correct, yes.
All right. Attorney Vicky Avena, she's professor at the UP of Law. At the UP. Ma'am, thank you so much for speaking to us, and I'm sure we'll be talking to you more and more in the coming days.
Okay, Pierre, most welcome.
Thank you.